What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to my kitchen. 2021 is finally here, man. Hopefully you had a good New Year's Eve. Hopefully you're not hungover. I must say I'm feeling pretty good myself. In the spirit of the new year, a lot of people have resolutions. They're gonna start dieting. They're gonna start trying to eat better, lose some weight, get a little more built. So what I'm gonna do today is empty my cupboards, empty my fridge, empty my pantry, lay it all out, and show you guys what I keep in my house to stay lean, build muscle, and just have a sustainable year-round anabolic lifestyle. So if you guys are ready to get another epic video underway, then as always, man, I'm here to do it for you. Let's do it! Yeah! I ain't gonna lie to you, pulling all of this from all the nooks and crannies in this kitchen is a little more difficult than she looks, but we got the essentials all right here. We got quite a bit to go over, so instead of just standing here talking about it, I really want you guys to be able to see everything I'm talking about. That way, if there's something you wanna buy, you got a good visual. So we're gonna switch this camera over to first person and get this going. Come on. All right, baby, let's get this show on the road. Starting off, you've seen this in every fitness thing you've ever watched, man. I always keep chicken breasts around because it's super cheap. I can get a big old pack of it. What is this one? 4.42 pounds, 229 a pound, 10 bucks. Chicken is so versatile. Very rarely, however, do I eat chicken like I used to, where it's like shit, just plain chicken breast or broth. I'm doing a lot of fun recipes with it. If you check out the channel, you know what I'm talking about. But I always keep chicken in stock, along with 96% lean ground beef. Basically, ground beef that they've zapped all the fat out, so it's more pure protein, not as lean as chicken. This is great, man. Make a couple burritos, do what you want to do. Speaking of burritos, man, tortilla selection is crucial. These are my favorite tortillas at the moment. La Banderita, carb counter, carb lean, 45 calories, a tortilla, and even get some protein in there. So I always say, man, it ain't about giving up the foods that you love. It's about just finding the better options. A regular tortilla, if it's 120 calories, you can eat almost three of these for one of them. You get to eat more, you get more fiber. You get what I'm saying here? All right, moving over here, man, I got fat-free Greek yogurt. We got fat-free cottage cheese. We got fat-free cream cheese. Now, none of these do I eat by themselves. It's pretty gross. These are more for recipe ingredients, right? By themselves, they're not that good. You start combining stuff, making some magic happen in your kitchen. These can be essentials. So I always have them on deck. I wanna be prepared if I wanna eat something. I want something special. I'm having a craving. I want to be able to knock that craving out and make something good. Something like this you guys might like. I found these pasta, notoriously carb heavy, calorie heavy. I like these because you just throw it in the microwave, and for the whole pack, it's only 300 calories, but you get 13 grams of protein. Pair that with some chicken and some sauce, you got a good meal. Orville Redenbacher Smart Pop, man. These are snack-sized popcorn bags, about 114 calories a bag. They're great. High volume, fill you up. Mix them with some baked Flamin' Hot Cheetos, you're in there. Whey protein powder. Once again, I rarely ever drink a shake. I'm usually making a smoothie or I'm making anabolic ice cream like a Blizzard or something. This is my favorite brand right here, man. Finalbossformance.com. Code RGF10 will get you some savings. Good stuff. Diet soda. All right, man. No lie, I drink probably 3 to 4 bottles of diet soda a day. Zero calories, so I ain't sweating it. They say diet soda is bad for you. I ain't seen no evidence of that. I drank pop when I was gaming and lazy and not working out, and I still drink pop. I just make the better choice. You can have unlimited these as opposed to one 200 calorie regular bottle of soda full of sugar. Take your pick. More is always better, in my opinion. If I want to actually make some pasta, I always keep some bonza chickpea pasta around, anabolic mac and cheese, whatever. Natural peanut butter, and we got sunflower butter. Now, I really don't ever get into these unless it's for a recipe, because these are slippery slopes. One spoon can easily be 200 calories, you eat the whole jar, and then your life's ruined. But those are more for recipes, but I do keep them around because I lack options. PB Fit powder, on the other hand, way better. It's peanut butter that they suck all the fat out of. It's like liposuction, and then they just give you all the protein and the flavor without none of the fast. This is mainly what I'm using in place of that. Plain white bread, baby. I'm eating French toast like every single day. I'll bake anabolic grilled cheeses, some things like that. So always have plain white bread around, but you always want to check them calories. Two slices for this is only 120 calories, I believe. And it's nice thick bread. It holds egg whites well for French toast. So, you know, you find a brand, you stick with it, bud. Bread don't make you fat. It's the calories that are making you fat. The carbs ain't making you fat. It's the calories that are making you fat, man. Don't be brainwashed. Check it out. We keep instant pancake and waffle mix, man. If you know, I do a lot of, I love waffles. I love pancakes. And these two are great, man, because you combine these with a couple other ingredients like your protein powder, your Greek yogurts, things like that, and you have some anabolic waffles, man. We're getting protein in every meal. That's the goal. More protein you're eating, the more thermogenic your body is, the more calories you're going to burn just breaking down that protein. So that's why I'm a fan of high protein diets in general, man. Just even if you aren't lifting weights, it just helps promote a leaner physique and helps put the fat loss in your favor as opposed to losing muscle. Sugar-free chocolate chips. You just saw this in the cookie dough video I dropped. This is my preferred brand. They're the lowest calorie ones. They don't add any sugar to it. Dark chocolate. Once again, recipes, I don't ever like just get get in there and eat chocolate chips. I mean, maybe sometimes, but who's keeping track? Fat-free mozzarella cheese. Man, you're gonna notice a trend here. I get a lot of fat-free products. Fat is where the majority of calories are coming from. I try to keep my diet pretty low fat. This is underrated in that it is 9 grams of protein for a 28 gram serving. So if you're eating protein pizzas, anabolic, any recipes to do, fat-free cheese is just an essential. Easy way to get extra protein in, and you're not giving up dairy. Dairy ain't making you fat, it's the calories. Speaking of that, ultra thin and crispy pizza crust, man. Wherever you go to the grocery store at, find these pre-made pizza crusts, and it makes dinner a snap. Toss it in the oven, layer it up with some cheese, put some toppings on it, and you got yourself an easy pizza. Each of these crusts is only 380 calories. So if I play my cards right, I can eat a whole pizza for dinner and make it like 700 calories, a ton of protein, low fat. I mean, it's, come on, guy, we're making better choices here. Don't order that Domino's or your whole life's ruined. And if you don't want a big old pizza, you can always move over and just get smaller ones too. You can see I got options here. Do I want a mini little personal pizza, or do I want to eat a whole one for dinner? What I got, I keep my options open. Joseph's Lavish Flatbread, man. These are great. Low calorie, lots of protein in here. Actually, for breakfast before I ate this, I fried up some egg whites, wanted a quick meal. Put them in here with some Dijon mustard and just ate it like a quick taco. It was like a 3-minute meal. Easy peasy. We got more fat-free cheddar cheese right here. Turkey pepperonis for that pizza. You can see it looks 70% less fat, less calories. You get what we're doing here? Moving into some sauces, man. My all-time favorite sauce, the one that gets the most love in this house, is my man G Hughes. He's got a whole line of sauces, sugar-free, very low calorie. And this stuff tastes incredible, man. The sweet and spicy is my favorite flavor, hands down, and I just love G. He's a real man. And then check it out, man. Fat-free mayo. Look at that. Not that I have mayo all the time, but if I have something I want to put a little splash of mayo on it, there's a way lower calorie version. Fat-free ranch. See what I'm saying here? Check it out. Fat-free Thousand Island dressing. And people always ask me, how do these taste? They assume it says fat-free, it doesn't taste that good. And I always try to say if it is like the first time you drank a beer, you were like, this doesn't taste good. Or the first time you had a coffee, you're like, this isn't good. But then you grow to actually like it. It just becomes what you drink, man. And that's just kind of my, that's how my sauces are. Like, these are all great to me because it's all I don't let myself have the really bad version. These are just what I do. We're making better choices. I can't stress that enough. Sugar-free sweetener, man. This is like powdered sugar, zero calories in this. It's great. It's got a good sharp little flavor. Obviously powdered sugar regularly ain't doing us any good. So this is just great. Sprinkle it on some brownies if I make them. Maybe put it on top of some French toast, some waffles. Just sprinkle it like fairy dust, bud. I like to keep some mustard in stock. We got some Dijon mustard in general. You don't really find bad mustards. If you do, those people are criminals. We got liquid egg whites. I always keep a ton of these in the fridge, man. I mean, that French toast every day, it's a recipe ingredient in a lot of things I'm making. So always keep that around. Tucked behind that. Told you we didn't have that much room. Fat-free ready whip, baby. Look at that. Like I'm saying, a lot of fat-free products, man. These should be like Walmart's. Everywhere's gonna carry some fat-free stuff. Just get the fat-free version. You're not gonna notice it. You get the same sensation, except you're not adding all the calories in, man. So I just can't stress that. Big bag of all-purpose white flour. I'm breading chicken a lot. I'm air frying boneless wings. Like last night, for instance, my dinner was a pound of anabolic boneless wings and Parmesan garlic sauce, man. Super great, and you gotta have a little bit of flour to make that happen. So I just always keep a bag around. It's like $2 a bag, man. Flour's cheap. Get you some. White queso. Boy, do I love cheese. Now, they don't make a fat-free version of this, unfortunately, but this stuff really ain't that bad if you portion it out. I mean, you dump the whole thing on something, that ain't too good for you, but you portion it out and you account for it, it's fine. So a little bit of this in a burrito that you bake or on the top of some nachos or like in a walking taco, like that recipe I just did, a little bit of this melted, it like spreads out. You get so much for like so little, if that makes sense. So love me some white queso. Unsweetened almond milk. I'm never really just drinking it, but I'm making smoothies all the time. Making anabolic blizzards and McFlurries, protein ice cream all the time. So unsweetened almond milk is just nice to have around. It's the lowest calorie milk thing you're gonna get. And I personally love it. And moving over here, I do have a protein bar. This is just a Quest bar. Normally I don't keep too many of these around, but I like just having like a couple just in case I'm in like a super quick hurry. Something comes up and I just gotta like eat something, but like I gotta maybe leave and go grab something. I don't really have time to cook. Although I can make something like 5 minutes. It's more of an excuse thing really, but having these around, it's nice to have. But we have our Anabars drop in actually this month if all goes well. So you'll no longer see them being marketed on my channel. Bet the house on that. I like to keep these microwavable rice packs in stock too, man. These are just too convenient. 90 seconds in the microwave, you got some cooked rice already done. So it's great for the hibachi fried rice video I just put out, man. It just makes it super simple. I think the easier it is to cook your food, so I try to keep my recipe simple, the more likely you are to actually follow them, right? So instead of cooking the rice, waiting 30, 40 minutes, I just use that. Just use that. Extra thin corn tortillas. These are great because three of them is only how many calories? 120. So I love to make chicken skillet tacos with some fat-free cheese. Super easy, quick meal that's delicious. These get crunchy, you fry them up, it's a win-win. Refried beans. These are great too if I'm making like a Mexican pizza. You get 130 gram serving for only 130 calories. Pretty filling, lots of fiber. You get some protein in there too. Oh yeah, and the sugar-free Jell-O packets. That's just, I'm not making Jell-O. That's an ingredient in the anabolic ice cream. But I think other than that, we got it. Let me show you my freezer real quick. I didn't want this stuff to get unthawed. But down in here, there's some frozen meats and some chickens, things like that. ButcherBox sponsors the channel, so they send me all sorts of like bison and things. Really cool, they'll just kind of send you some stuff. Get a big box of meat. You always have it, let it thaw, you're good. But the main thing I wanted to show you guys was my collection of frozen fruit. We got mangoes, pineapples, and strawberries, man. I've been doing like a fruit smoothie every single night. Put a big old straw in there, big old cup. Can't really beat it. I do love getting some fruit in. It's a good way to get some fiber and your sweetness. Really fill yourself up with minimal calories. And like I said, other than meat, you know what I mean? We got meat down in here. And then a burrito my girlfriend bought and never ate. My girlfriend, this stuff, something my girlfriend eats, man. She definitely ain't like me. She eats these. I'm not eating that. Oh, and then also too, I don't eat a whole lot of vegetables. I'm not gonna lie to you. But things like these stir fry starters, if you really want to make something quick, you can dump that whole bag in a skillet, preheat it, cook it up real quick, add some protein, and you got yourself a meal. And I think that finishes us up. And this is basically what I keep my house stocked up with. There's more here. There's more up there. It just doesn't all fit on this counter, and some of it isn't as relevant. But I felt like this was the best stuff to show you guys, man. I get asked a lot when I do these videos how expensive this is. And to be honest, I don't know. I just kind of start replacing stuff as I run out. I always kind of keep the same things in stock. I haven't went and done like a large grocery trip in a while because I always just have what I need here. And if there's a rule, I would say that if you want to start 2021 off on the right foot, something I do personally that helps me a ton with this whole dieting stuff is that I refuse to eat out at all except for Saturday nights. I have one cheat meal every week. I do go out to my dinner every Saturday night. But other than that, every other meal I'm eating are meals I'm preparing and cooking myself. And I think that as soon as you take control of your own nutrition and you quit giving that control to these restaurants, you're giving them your money, you're letting them dump oils and crap all over your food, you don't know what you're putting in your body. I think as soon as you relinquish that control from them and you take control of it yourself, that's when things really start turning around. I believe that for real. And if you want the ultimate 2021 Kickstarter, man, that RJF Anabolic Cookbook, link in my description. All of my recipes are in here. Every food combination that I talked about in this video, all those beautiful thumbnails you're seeing all over my channel, the ice creams, the things like that, man. The thing is, I love what I eat. I love this diet. This does not feel like a bodybuilding diet to me at all. I've been able to stay in the best shape of my life. This doesn't feel like work. I love what I do, and it all comes down to making the foods that you actually enjoy. And with this cookbook, man, that's what it is. It tells you every ingredient, the exact macros, calories, to break down everything. So you know what you're putting in your body, and when you do that, I just don't see how you can lose, for real. And you get it once, you get every future recipe I have for free, man. It's the gift that keeps on giving. Appreciate you guys, as always. Smash the thumbs up button for me. Comment anything down below for that algorithm. Subscribe if you're not subscribed. We have a ton of great videos coming in 2021, man. We're gonna crush it. Mark my words. And I appreciate you guys as always. And until next time, ladies and gentlemen, I will see each and every one of you at the next video. See you guys. We out of here.